All right, well, here you are for the section two of Wednesday's work here. We were thinking about what we should do for this video in between during our break, you know. Finally thought we ought to do some role plays.
Yeah.
Like, we've done a lot of them over the years, and you know, it's good practice. You know, we don't have a script or anything like a movie. It's not done like that. We do it like a role play, playing the what we'd say and what other people would say and what people were helping us say and groups, like the groups we want to do.
All right.
You know, these are a lot of fun to do. So, and we just use our psychic minds and tell us what to say next and just open them up. And tell us the situations, it just kind of appears like we're getting a case study to use. Yeah. But both of us, first impressions was to have somebody, let's say to do someone that's killed someone, you know, in one of the groups. And okay, that's what his first impression was, like, so was mine.
Yeah.
So, and let's see how it goes. Like this, and when you listen to this, like just see it as like when you're sitting in a big room in a circle with maybe 20 people in a circle, while we're sitting there, and then you're there, and then Pete and like this guy or whoever this is that we're role playing is here.
Yeah, right.
And like just imagine, put yourself there, and then just go with us on this.
Yeah, we're just talking.
Playing different parts, playing us, playing the person being helped, playing group members.
All right.
You should be able to figure it out. It'd be pretty easy. Okay, let me write one more thing down before we do this. Let's see what I see. I even see what people look like. All right, it's a little short dude. Little short, skinny dude. Sitting there kind of like this. You know, with his head down, you know, like his short hair, it's a black dude, real dark skin.
Okay.
You see him?
With like a black t-shirt on.
Yeah, he's just sitting here like this.
Yeah.
Maybe like 16, 17 years old, even young.
Alright.
Now he looks young as hell.
Yeah.
You know, just sitting there slumped over like this. You know, no eye contact. Now, I didn't choose that. It's what psychically has been given to us. For some reason, you know,
popped into our brain.
Here we go. And then I return to him, and like, you know, all right. So we help the last person. We turn to him, and like, look, bro, what's up with you, man? You know, you're sitting over there, man. You're sitting so quiet, man. I can tell there's a lot of pain in you. Not just in my own psychic sense, which you know we've got.
Yeah.
You know, Jeremy too. But
I can tell
there's something going on.
Just looking at you, man. You're just sitting there. Out the vibe that something's wrong, so kind of come out and tell us what's going on, man.
He's like this and shaking his head, and he's like, I don't know, man. It's hard for me to talk about this, man, but it's messing me up. I don't know what to say, man.
I'm like, well, just first, just kind of calm down, relax, take some deep breaths, breathe in, breathe out.
Right.
You know, talk to us about it, man. It's all right. You know, we're not going to judge you.
No one's telling anyone anything. No one's judging you. You know, we're here to listen and we're here to help, you know? He's like, man, I don't know. I don't want to get in no trouble.
We can convince you all day, brother, that we won't tell anybody or we're not going to talk to anybody. But you have to first put yourself in the shoes, you know, where we are, and know that we're not going to say anything or talk or judge you or any of these things. So please, man, just... If you want to release pain, talk to us.
He just sits there for a minute, and I just see him like, he's like, why did I do that? This guy screams, why did I do that? You know, it just starts coming out, you know. You see that too? Banging on this flat, banging shit.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
He's like, I was so stupid, what was I thinking? You know, now I don't know what to do anymore. And, you know,
first off, brother, you're not stupid, whatever you've done, whatever you're ashamed of, you know, we can look past it, we're going to get past this, we're going to talk about it, we're going to
talk about
it, brother. We're trying to help you, but you feel you're in a lot of pain.
Yeah, me and Jeremy do this all the time, bro. You know, You know, there's nothing we haven't heard about. We've heard lots of crazy shit. You'd be surprised at what you're saying about what you're going through. It might not be that big, you know, compared to some of the other stuff, but it's still important to all of us. And then I hear like a lady, she's like, come on, little bro, it's all right, you know, you heard us too, you know, you heard us talking, so, you know, it's all right, say it, you need help. It's like a little older lady, maybe in her 40s, on the other side of the room. I saw her speak up.
I hear other people in the room go, yeah, come on, brother, come on, speak, tell it.
He's like, you know, he's like slowly shaking his head, like, he's like, man, I've done killed somebody, you know, I've done killed somebody, man, I don't know what to do anymore, it's fucking me up in the head, this motherfucking shit, man, you know, I feel so stupid, and you know, now I don't know what to say anymore, you know, I can't deal with my own self anymore, I feel so bad, you know. Yeah, I feel like so dumb for doing some of this shit. I know it wasn't right, but he's like, man, I know it wasn't right, you know, but, you know, what do I do now?
He's like, I was so caught up in the moment, and it just, things were going this way and that way, and I just felt cornered, and I just, boom, you know.
Yeah.
Took a life, you know.
And, like, you know, and then I said, I heard that somebody else is speaking up. He's like, look, I've done it too, you know. Another guy across the room, he's like, look, brother, you know, I've been through it myself, you know. He's like, you know, it's not easy, you know.
Yes. You're feeling a lot of shame and guilt right now, man. You know, you're going through a lot of stress, anxiety. You don't know who to talk to. You come to the right place, I think.
Yeah.
But trying to help you first know that nobody ever really dies.
Yeah. And like, your secret's safe with everybody here.
Yeah.
Like, you know, that goes for us, all of us in this room, as we all know. Everything stays in here. We're not going to tell anybody anything. That's, you know, that's how it is. So feel comfortable. It's all right. You can be comfortable. We'll talk about things.
Yes, and this world is very serious, and you're taking a life.
But not in the next world.
Yeah, maybe not so much, you know, in this room necessarily, but in life, that you take a life, you know, people will be angry. There's people that are more and stuff.
More revenge, a lot of this stuff.
I want to put you in jail.
But
that's not why we're here, man.
That's not our job. We don't do that shit.
So
how you come to terms with yourself?
Yeah.
He's like, what do you see? He's just sitting there. Now, he's out. I see him. All right. This is what I'm seeing in my mind. Now he's just sitting there just quietly, and then he started, I think he's just, I hear him like choking up almost, like he's about to start crying or something. You see that?
Yeah.
You know?
I tell him, look, man, if you want to cry, it's okay, cry. If you want to hit the floor,
exactly.
Anything, you know, we'll try to, like in our groups, we're going to try to provide
mattresses to beat, and shit like that.
Maybe like a sword to
hit. Or to hit it with and stuff.
The ground, you know, or whatever, then make a snapping noise.
I think this, like, I can always see him jumping up and leaping towards it too. But I can see the mattress there. He's just leaping towards it, screaming. You know,
when I get it out, brother.
He's like, like that. Just screaming. You know, that, like, get it out, man. And I see me and Jeremy just sitting down on our knees on the floor next to him. Sit there with him, helping him out.
You know, I'm trying to help you understand this, my brother. Like, you know.
He's like, I don't want to go to hell. God to put me in hell.
That's exactly what I was going to say to him.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, you're not going to hell for this. You know, you haven't committed something, or you're going to go to the fiery pits and burn, and you're not going to be judged at the gate, man.
Like, forgive me, God, please. I don't know if you can. I don't know. I don't want to go to hell.
You're forgiven, you know. First off, you're forgiven, you know. You are forgiven in any which way, shape, or form that you look at. You know, you're okay, you know.
Yeah, okay. I see Christ appearing in the room in that seminar and here, too. But actually, I can see him popping through from the other side at that moment, you know.
Yeah, just being like.
Being like, you know.
You are forgiven. Don't worry. You know,
yeah.
We make a point to say it's not necessarily crisis for doing